the play of Gerald Green, so key last season, both off the bench and as a starter. And, yeah, that hasn't changed. Still got the high percentage finish as he slides in here to the chair to our left. Good to see you, my friend.
What's up, man? Thanks for having me.
Great to have you here as well, and just always got that 10,000-watt smile on your face.
Oh, man, I just like to smile, I guess, you know. My mom always said it's better to smile better than frown, so you know, I'm just trying to just smile as much as possible.
And a good reason to smile, just because when you look at this roster, when you look at the talent, last year a team that was picked to win 15, 19 games, playing with a chip on your shoulder. Mm-hmm. Just talk about the different kind of mindset that you have and that this team has coming in here to this campaign.
Well, I think this organization makes you smile. You know, when you come to work every day knowing that these guys is putting their best foot forward, trying to get better, and the direction that we're going and that we're headed, it just makes everybody just, you know, smile. So I think for me, man, it just makes my job a lot more easier just to knowing that I know I'm not going to be the only one out here trying to get better, knowing that everybody's on the same page. Our goal is to make the playoffs. Our goal is to turn this organization around.
Gerald, we talked earlier about your perseverance and how you came in out of high school and you really had, you know, took some time to find your way. And you came here last year and really just blossomed in this system, in this city, with this franchise. And just talk about what it is here that allowed for you to come out and really showcase your talents and abilities.
You know what, man? Honestly, I have to thank this organization tremendously, man. I think they were the ones who believed in me from the jump or from the trade. I'm pretty sure they had several opportunities to trade for somebody else. Ryan traded for me and gave me an opportunity to be successful here. You know, that's the biggest thing. When you got somebody that's behind you and backs you up 100% as a player, it makes that basket just a little bit more wider for you to make shots down. And it makes me want to just run through a brick wall for not only for those players, but for the organization as well.
You know, one of the things Grant and I were talking about is with the departure of Channing Frye. Channing was kind of a vocal leader, mm-hmm. a leader by example, if you will. And one of the things that we're curious about, that I think a lot of Suns fans are curious about, who is going to step into that role? Is that something now, as a second-year member of this team, this organization, you'll feel a little bit more open about, you know, sharing? As Grant said, when it's time to bring guys together to kind of, you know, knock heads a little bit if things are going off the rails, because that's the one thing when you look at this locker room, who's going to emerge as that leader?
Well, you know what? I've always been taught leaders they always lead by example. So that's why sometimes I try to just try to do things the right way. And, you know, I've been through a lot as far as my career. I've been ups and downs. And I've seen a lot through playing in different leagues. So some of the advice that I can get to these young guys, I will give to them, because I don't want them to go through the same struggles that I went through coming into the league. And and for the most part, just, you know, making sure that you working hard and trying to run your sprints as hard as you can, giving it your all. I think that once rookies see that, hey, man, Gerald's been in the league for this long and he's going this hard, I should be able to go as hard as well. And that's what's going to get everybody better.
Gerald, you talked about playoffs this year, and certainly those are the expectations. What do you think you guys need to do in a very tough Western Conference to make the playoffs this upcoming season?
Honestly, Grant, I think that we need to really, really just not take games for granted. I think that when we play teams like the Oklahoma City Thunder, the Miami Heat, the Los Angeles Clippers, I mean, we're right there last year. You know, we were playing against the best. We competed against them. And when we played against those teams that was had an under 500 record, we played down to their level. And at this league, everybody knows you can't take every game for granted. You got to win the games that you're supposed to win, and the games that you're not supposed to win, you got to win at least 50% of those games. So I think this year, I think that's the lesson that we've all learned, is we can't take each game for granted. We got to play every game like they're the same person. And I think that's one thing I think we've all learned.
Yeah, and to that point, 11 games you lost that were decided by 5 points or less. Mm-hmm. So with this unit basically coming back intact, you feel better about those late game execution situations?
Well, you learn from that. That's one thing you do. When you've been in those situations so many times, you learn how to get out of the certain situations, how to come on top on certain situations. So I think that last year was all a learning experience for all of us. I think that everybody was in a position of really fighting for a spot that nobody never really played for. That's, for instance, I played the most minutes I've ever played in my career. I think the Morris is the same as well, Tucker. So, well, everybody had a lot bigger role last year. And we were successful. We weren't as successful as we wanted to be. But this year, that's why we were so anxious to come back this year. Hopefully, we can reach our goal.
Well, listen, great to have you on board here,
man,
and look forward to another successful season.
Good luck this year, man.
You got it. Gerald Green.
Thank you so much.